website, which there would be a link on the website for that, phoenixprogramsinc.org. We've been spending a lot of time over the last couple of months getting out there and making sure that a lot of the information that we're putting on our website is explaining some of the things that we're talking about here today, the long-term recovery, voices of recovery. So it would be worth the time to go and look at some of those research studies that we've got listed.
Now, just to review for folks who might not be familiar with Phoenix Programs, because as you reminded us, Simon and I have correctly changed our thought process to make it be Phoenix Programs.
Yes, thank you.
Most people might still remember Phoenix House. Can you tell us just in summary what it is that you do at Phoenix Programs so folks who might know someone who needs your services can access
them? Right. We are still excited with the fact that 9 months ago we moved into our new 28,000 square foot building over on the corner of Providence and Vandiver, and that was the fulfillment of many years of dreams, visions, coming together, lots of community support to create a facility there which actually highlights what we do best, and that is create a community, create a safe and friendly, engaging environment with a lot of outpatient focus. So going back to your question, Phoenix House was strictly, the focus was on residential, and what we know now after studying what is best practice in this field is that issue of maintenance, ongoing treatment, which means that the outpatient is much more, not just more appropriate, but also more economical. So we've got ways of providing specific treatment packages for people that work around their schedule, work around their family obligations, and that's where the name change came in.
So how do people, I mean, how do you, would you gain admittance to one of your programs? I mean, are people referred by doctors? Do you get calls from family members? But do you see what I'm saying?
Yes,
how would you get
yes
in?
And yes. Yeah. But really from multiple areas. Certainly you picked two of the larger ones, healthcare professional and family member. Also friend. Other community agencies. We've had referrals from faith community. Some folks have had experience in the law enforcement area, so there might be a referral from a probation officer. But overall, what we really want to emphasize, and Heather's specialty in prevention really allows us to do this, and that is that early intervention also matters. Years ago, there was this idea that somebody had to be really bad, have a serious problem before intervention and help was even a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
Now what we're seeing is earlier on, if an employer, a family member, a loved one is able to talk about this, we can come in with some treatment packages that the whole family can support. So, for example, we can try family therapy with some outpatient groups, and then you're monitoring that individual's level of success. It's much less about compliance. I think that's another thing that we've seen is our change with Phoenix Programs and our new facility, is that this awareness, this coming to understand one's own illness, is much more about being able to interact with the professionals, with the others in the treatment center. Is gone is the culture of just do what I say, comply with the rules. So we really emphasize our community, the awareness, taking responsibility for self. When you see all those things happening in a group, it really is something magical to watch, because you've got someone who is giving because they've had some experiences themselves, their stories, their recovery struggles, but yet their successes, and then someone who is eager to hear that, and everyone benefits from that.
All right, you said taking responsibility. So lately, while we've got you two here, this is a good question for you, I think, and that is, of late, I'm talking about the last 2 or 3 years, every big celebrity who's got themselves in trouble by wandering off the path of merit or bliss, shall we say, Tiger Woods being the most obvious example, one of the things they always end up doing, and I'm always suspicious whether this is just a big PR move or if there's something to it, they wander off and they're in a sex addiction program. Now, there's a lot of things that tell you, you know, sex can be an addiction because you're talking about the brain again. So, is there something to this, Heather, when these celebrities go off for this? I mean, obviously, he's protecting his brand, I think, but is there something to it, substantively?
You know, since we don't treat that, I can't answer that. Sorry, Simon.
That was going to be my next question.
Yeah, because you really had a great lead-in for that, but so I can't speak to that.
Yeah, but you guys are in the field.
What I would say is when we look at anything where people would get off track in their lives,
mm-hmm.
what does it take to get back on track? We specialize in helping people get back on track
right.
from substance abuse issues. There are certainly other issues out there that get people off track. And I believe, as you do, it has to do with brain chemicals.
Mm-hmm.
But recovering from anything that gets us off track is going to be a skill set. Recovery from a substance abuse issue is going to be a skill set. It's not about just not using. Well, certainly that's a big part of it. But you have to figure out what else to do.
We have to figure out what it is that caused you to fill that gap in that way in the first place.
And not running away mm-hmm. necessarily to a center
mm-hmm.
that is in some, you know, more like a spa
exactly.
kind of an atmosphere.
Exactly. They're hardly slumming it, yeah.
Right. So that's another piece of what we really try to do, and that is emphasize what we call our therapeutic community, our therapeutic culture, so that what Heather just said, the reinforcers are there. How does someone achieve that self-discipline and self-awareness? We actually make that happen within our therapeutic community. So we could tell you stories all day long
yeah.
of how people maybe had a pattern of avoiding conflict or avoiding confrontation or maybe glamorizing some of their days of use. And the therapeutic community will actually, in a very positive way, ask that person to rethink that, to maybe set up those pathways that describe that activity in a different way.
I'm always looking for ways. How could I in 30 seconds explain to somebody what the therapeutic community is?
Mm-hmm.
Ugh. So a counselor the other day had told me about that we had some outside speakers come in the group, and he checked and he said Heather, I was really kind of having an off day, but you know, we all have those. And he went in the group and he said that the people in the group weren't being real disrespectful, but a few of them were nodding off, maybe had feet on chairs, and the counselors asked people to be attentive, etc., encourage that behavior. And this counselor, instead of coming in, I think what might have happened in a conventional group might have been if somebody come in and said, hey, feet off the chairs, everybody sit up and pay attention, you know, we're back in junior high or something, I don't know. What this counselor did in a very skilled, very real way said, I gotta say, I'm kind of having an off day. Is anybody else having an off day? And he said, most people in the group said, yeah, we are too. He said, you know, I just, okay, we're having some people from outside in the community come in, and I'm just wondering if we can rise to the occasion and kind of sit up and give them some more attention, even though I know this is kind of a hard thing for me, it's kind of hard for you. Do you think we can do that? And they all said, yeah, okay, we can do that. And so then he left the room, and on the way out, they said, thanks for calling that to our attention. That's therapeutic community. He said we. He inserted himself into that community. We would have stood back and said he corrected them, and they thanked him for it. And that's what he did. That was a skillful, positive way to encourage them to the right behavior.
Anita Lynn has to do that with our 2.5-year-old.
Good luck with that.
Yeah.
I'll need to the counselors.
All right, thanks. Guys, we're out of time. Once again, Ragtag, this Sunday, the 26th, and it starts, well, actually 11 o'clock is when you start the whole program, right?
Yeah, I think we'll be there at 11.
Okay.
Film at 1 and just show up. Things happen.
And website.
Yes.
Very
thank
quickly.
You.
Can you give us the website,
Deborah? PhoenixProgramsInc.org.
And if you forget that, just do a search on Phoenix Programs, and it'll come up.
Thanks
Phoenix
a lot.
Programs. Thank you
Deborah
Bestie,
very
Heather
much.
Heather Holland from Phoenix Programs. We appreciate your time. 9:55. News is next on News Talk 1400 KFRU Columbia.
The morning meeting on News Talk 1400.